Hello everyone, welcome back to Real Life. I hope you're having a wonderful day. In this episode, we're traveling back to Ontario during the Second World War, but this has little to do with fighting overseas, rather the beginning of major road construction in the Sudbury and North Bay region. The Yundt Bros Construction, based in Stratford, Ontario, was a well-established company to at least the 1930s. This is part one of three parts. The unknown cinematographer, likely a family member of the company, captured this Kodachrome color footage during an extensive road trip from Stratford to Sudbury and region, where they spent some time building roads. Along the way, there are minor mishaps, lots of faces of employees, and plenty of scenery in the Canadian Shield. The war effort required enormous amounts of iron, nickel, and other metals. Inco's Sudbury nickel mines were critical from the outset of the war. The nickel operations in the Sudbury Basin were booming due to growing global tensions and increased spending on military budgets. Sudbury and the northeastern Ontario gold mining centers of Timmins and Kirkland Lake were among the few economic bright spots in a country devastated by the Great Depression. As a result, road construction was increasingly necessary to access new sites. Yundt Bros and other contractors were kept busy fulfilling that need. The company employed a unique rolling two-story bunkhouse of the likes that I've never seen, as well as some vehicles that today would likely be considered oversized. You'll see town arches in Sudbury, North Bay, Huntsville, and other places. Those town arches, once common across Canada, are long gone now, a reminder of a different age. Sudbury's town arch employed a well-lit V for victory. The same V in the victory nickel that was a Canadian coin produced between 1943 and 1945. Enjoy and look forward to parts 2 and 3. Thanks for watching. Have a great day. Be kind, and we'll see you next time on Real Life.